Okay, so next up is Darkest Dungeon. I don't remember where we left off, but I remember hating life a lot while playing it. So we're somewhere between hating life and only somewhat hating life, I think. If you thought the salt was real in Warcraft,
ruin
wait until you see this.
Has come to our family. You remember our venerable house.
Tonight is salt night, in which Vinny practices his Zen fucking monk meditation methods and fails miserably. I lost more than 45% of them, Chris. I lost almost all of
my senses. All my life I could feel an insistent gnawing in the back of my mind. It was a yearning, a thirst for discovery that could be neither numbed nor sated.
Yeah, I lost a lot of good characters last time. Okay, one second, everyone. I remember, I got like a bullet point of things to help me in Darkest Dungeon from someone named Dirk Trash. Okay, you never bring stressed out people on a mission unless you have a jester. Better to focus on clear enemies one at a time rather than spreading out your damage. Right. Man at arms. Have him guard a party member, then activate riposte. Alternate between guard and riposte. Occultists. You want to use demon pull, who are weaker in the front. This is good. You fight where you spent two whole turns clearing corpses with the leper. When your characters say something, why do we tarry? That means they're coming on the next turn, okay? Okay. Thank you, Dirk Trash. I appreciate the advice. Advice acquired. So Cryosnake is missing. Sort by level. Poshel. Why do I have a fucking character named Poshel? I don't remember this. Oh fuck, guys, why do I have a character named Poshel? Jethro's healing. I'm gonna bring I'm gonna do a low level mission for money. Also, someone said get a bleed thing off of Mandrake. So I don't know who you are that said that, but I will take your advice. Plus 20% to bleed skill. Oh, I don't know why the fuck that's even on. You're right, that's trash. That's bad. We don't want that. ...90% of room battles. Alright, so we're gonna just start off... well, Jethro here will do that. Okay. Bring Pavel along for healing. 50% heal skills, good, okay. Who do we want to level up a little bit? Poshel? Why do I have... two occultists. I'm gonna bring Vauville. Because we were just talking about, these fellas. Let's see, we have retribution. We don't have defend. So defend and retribution. So I need to get defend on this dude. And then, I guess we could bring along... Since Dirk gave me this information, we could bring along Dirk. right? That's a pretty decent party, I'd say. So for those new to this game, I'm not going to explain it in full, but let's just say it's a turn-based RPG of sorts with lots of random elements where your characters suffer from permadeath. And it is one of the most heartbreaking games that I've ever played. So that should give you an idea. Dirk is good. Dirk is good. What about you? Alright. So, Jethro is with us to give us more money. This will be a pretty... should be straightforward. I mean, you never know. I might encounter a fucking space-time dimension-breaching alien called the Collector that wants to steal all of the dicks in the party. Which is officially two dicks, as far as I know. All right, so we're going to the cove.
The smell of rotting fish is almost unbearable.
What an amazing message to start a fucking level with.
The smell of fish.
Speaking of the smell of rotting fish, Too Many Games was generally being, oh look, there it is, there's a cut open whale. Too Many Games this year was generally not too smelly. Don't get me wrong, here and there, there was a little smelliness. You don't go to a convention and not get smells. Mike noticed, actually, on the Thursday, on the day before the convention started, Mike noticed a little bit of nasty BO. Which is weird, because it was only people putting the place together and helping. So, I'm not sure how that happened, and then the rest of the days were pretty clean. So the bow meter wasn't... Oh, okay. Thank you, creepy coral. So the bow meter was not high at this convention. No butt butter. It was a little hot. It's the summer, so you know, these things can definitely get a little bit hot and sweaty. But generally, a very clean convention this year, from my perspective. What do you have? Bad humors. Minus 20% max HP. All because I touched a fucking stone. Alright, well, we're not touching stones ever again. Good job, Vauville. Oh, I have to have the... I have to have the antiquarian touch all the things. Forget about that. Not playing a game for a few weeks can do this. Someone said, what's the semicircle above the characters' heads at random intervals mean? That's stress. You see those little white bars? That is your stress level. If you reach 100 stress, if it reaches the end, then your character becomes stressed out, and you A number of things can happen, but mostly insanity.
Curious is the trap maker's art. His efficacy unwitnessed by his own eyes.
God damn it. What do the antiquarians do? They allow more treasure to... more valuable treasure spawns. They're not really good fighters, but they are valuable to have in your party because they do good damage. Are they good? They give you good loot, antiquarians. Dear God.
Be gone.
Yeah. Yeah, Dirk. No, don't do that. Don't buff your friend.
How quickly the tide turns.
Ow. Even with extra protection, that still fucking hurt.
Continue the onslaught. Destroy them all.
Please. Retribution. Retribution plus guard. Yeah, I'll be using this combination, defender and retribution, very often from this point forward. Look at that. That is a fuckload of a combination.
Confidence.
Look at that.
As the enemy crumbles.
Oh, that is amazing. No wonder.
Their formation.
I have never utilized this character properly.
The offensive.
Trapped. Damn it. I needed a key. That would have been nice too. God damn it. If you hover over the trap, a little meter appears. Yeah. Oh. Okay, that doesn't really matter too much. They switch the party around. Which is important for newcomers. Where your characters are positioned is, dependent. Certain moves are dependent on that. Someone in chat just said, "You can't get it off!" I thought for sure I was gonna be able to kill that jellyfish.
Vision. The end approaches. As the fiend falls, a faint hope blossoms.
This thing can heal? Oh, it's a shot. It's a shaman. Remove shaman. Yeah, this motherfucker needs to be healed constantly. Especially now that he's got minus 20% HP from hepatitis or whatever.
Another one falls. Success so clearly in view. Or is it
we're not touching that
trick of the light?
We are not touching that fucking thing. Oh, whoops. I should've. Oh, we surprised them. Good, good, good. Okay, we go for the occultist lady. Because she can stress us out, and that does not need to be happening. Damn it. Yes! Eradicated. Nice. Dirk is fucking beastly powerful. We can go for the brawler next, since I think that's one we'll be able to remove fairly quickly. There you go. That's right. Good defend. Good heal. That was not the target I had. Oh, right. You stunned to remove the guard from another target. I understand. Okay.
Masterfully executed.
Masterfully executed. Brother. Look at all this shit. Fucking Vaudeville living up to the definition of being a fucking tank. He's dead next round. Just punch this motherfucker back a little bit. Give him a good stun. I bleed. Dead.
The weapon that cuts.
Perfect.
On its own.
Fish fella should be dead soon. Oh, that's not good. I should have defended him. Dirk is not doing that great. Dirk needs some pretty substantial healing. Yeah! Now that is what I'm talking a fucking about! Crush!
Yep. Hey, it's me.
A trifling victory. But a victory, nonetheless.
Yeah, put beans on it. Yeah, rub the beans on it.
Ask Mike about rubbing beans on it. Next time you're in his chat, just ask him about that real quick.
Yeah, put the beans on it. Yeah.
The ground quakes.
Shovel the clam in the room. I will shovel the clam after this. Protect this dude this time. Resisted that, huh? Just a little bit more. Okay, perfect. Good. That worked out.
This is how a life is taken.
Should have went for this dude. That would have been good, wouldn't it? I don't know why I didn't. I don't know why I'd keep disregarding the focus fire. You know, protect. Protect doesn't necessarily protect against, only one. Protect doesn't necessarily protect against multi-attacks, huh? Okay, well, you're fucking dead now. Enjoy that. You're dead now? Go fuck yourself. Good, good. Oh, what's this? You're gonna die too? That's surprisingly annoying. I think it's more the dudes with the blanket fire move in the back.
Brought low and driven into the mud.
I don't know why going backwards is such a problem for these folks. You know what? Let me tell you how much of an asshole I am. I should have opened it with the fucking antiquarian. What is wrong with me? God damn it. The salt is so real.
As the light gains purchase, spirits are lifted, and purpose is made clear. We will find all manner of great and terrible things in this watery tomb.
Still pretty good overall. Good haul. Red plague. Yeah, Vaudeville just has fucking plagues, diarrhea, rabies, scabies, babies.
In truth, I cannot tell how much time has passed since I sent that letter.
And now I have to spend, like, inordinate amounts of money getting Vaudeville fixed up for the next, like, 4 rounds. Or at least 2. So we can de-stress a little bit, and see what missions are available next. I have a little bit of money now, not too much, but enough that I could actually go on a medium mission, and I might go on a red mission to end this. But let's do veteran first, medium. 3 holy relics. For a highwayman, there's a weapon there. This is for anyone. Brawler's gloves, plus 25% damage if in position 1. That sounds pretty fucking great. You lose a little bit of speed, but that's really good. Decent arbalast thing. Activate 3 shrines. Minus 20% stress damage. Plus 50% heal skills for an antiquarian if I kill the brigand 12-pounder, which I'm not doing. Okay. We're gonna do this one for the, brawler. Brawler's gloves. That. Alright, so, brawler's gloves. I want to embark on a mission. Let's see, which one? What are we doing? Okay, Follett. We've got a new trinket for him, possibly. Actually, I think he already has that. Yeah, he's got it. I could get... No, I can't do two of the same. Accuracy plus damage. So we're gonna... Yeah, we'll bring this dude. This dude's pretty fucking awesome. He's a master leper. So, I mean, as much as you can be a master at being a diseased, you know, like, probably very unhappy dude, he's mastered it. Maybe we'll bring Willoughby 3. Just for shits and giggles. Willoughby 3. We can bring Mandrak for healing. Do I have a jester available? I got With Harvest, Stress Heal, Battle Ballad, Slice Off. Yeah, this is good. Perfect. This is a good fucking jester. Oh, this is a good fucking healer. Good. Very good. I like this team. I have high hopes for this team. Okay, got a bunch of things already leveled up. These skills are all pretty much good. This will be the mission we lose Willoughby 3. As I'm like, yeah, they're all good. Making cattle. They're all good. Nope. Upgrade the sword. We can also upgrade Willoughby's weapon. Maybe. Let's see if Mandrak needs... Mandrak could use some defense. Let's face it. You know, you want your healers to live. Typically. Alright, that should be good. Let's see, provisions. I may need to sell something real quick. I'm gonna sell like a trash trinket. Or a duplicate. Yeah, that's good enough. Yeah, I guess that's good. Maybe I need to sell one more trash trinket. Bleedstone. Did my stream just go down? Oh no, my fucking my browser froze. More than my browser froze. My whole fucking explorer just froze. Hey, if you're still here watching this... hello? I can't see you. No, it was just Firefox. Give me a sec, guys. Let me remove the fox. One sec. Bringing it back up. Okay. I'm back. I can't wait for people to go and chat how Firefox sucks. And then more people will be like, hey, Chrome sucks. No, Chrome is good. No, use Chrome. It's great. And then Chrome sucks. And then Firefox sucks. And then generally just shit on all of the choices I make. And then a war will engage. Over personal choice of browser. But that's life, I guess, isn't it? I suppose you could say life is irregular. Just use Internet Explorer. Yes! Yes, Internet Explorer. Isn't that Edge now? It's called Edge. Microsoft Edge. You wanted a better browser. We gave you a better name. But the real question is, can it shoot browsers? That's the real question.
I knew all these paths once. Now they are as twisted as my own ambitions.
Edged is not IE. Oh, okay. Never mind then. I thought they did like a thing where they tried to make Internet Explorer cool again by renaming it. I had no idea that it was a different thing. If it is, in fact, a different thing, I just don't know. I want to know what that dude just said, because let me tell you something, he's a scumbag for saying it. Problem with the Jester is you can't really attack in the first few positions. Let's just get rid of some of that stress real quick. And we get a buff too. Oh! That's my... You missed your fucking move sound. It was almost a Wilhelm. Why is that move allowed, you scum? You frothing scum. I'm making very questionable decisions in this game right now.
As the enemy crumbles.
He said that the Vinesauce stream is really good, and the characters went mad as a result. The absolute madman.
Yeah, dodge. Yeah. Yeah, yeah, put the beans on it. Yeah. Good. Grab them in. Yep.
This is what happens when you keep a madman alive longer than he should be.
Their formation is broken. Maintain the offensive.
Hey, I got an achievement for that. Really good fucking self-heal, by the way. Let it be known that lepers heal themselves very nicely. good bleed. That's good bleeding. Stress heal a little bit.
The ground quakes.
There you go.
Unforeseen. Unforgiving.
Well. You can't heal your own stress as a jester. That is definitely a drawback.
Continue the onslaught. Destroy them all.
Should we check out the tent?
Finding the stuff is only the first test. Now it must be carried home.
It's like that time my family and I went on vacation, and I looked inside a tent when we were camping, and there was a giant, like, purple, like, slug in the corner of the tent. And I didn't know what it was. It scared the shit out of me. It was really slimy looking, and it was just left there. It was just abandoned. And then I found out years later it was actually just a dildo. Also, that story was a lie.
As the fiend falls, a faint hope blossoms.
Oh, that's fucking gross.
Annihilated.
Yeah, mark that target. See, it has the mark on it, so the bounty hunter's gonna do more damage against it. I hate how it fucking creates a new target. That's so annoying. You can have the jester stress heal himself? Oh, okay. Also, I sent out my 3DS today to get repaired. So I'm hoping we'll have some luck pretty soon. Within the next week, I'd imagine I'd get it back. So as soon as that happens, we'll get more Kirby.
Yeah!
Oh, I don't know what is happening with these fucked up Sonic noises tonight, guys. I'm so sorry. Oh yeah, you can stress heal yourself. For some reason, I thought you couldn't click yourself for that.
Success so clearly in view. Or is it merely a trick of the light?
Sometimes a tree is just a tree. Like, you get to the tree, and you're expecting more. And it's just a tree. It's not Treebeard. I don't think I've ever expected more from a tree than just being a tree. At no point did I say to myself, I wonder if there's more to this. I remember, though, actually, there was a tree near my house that I really liked because it was cool. And I was playing with the beans
that it
came with.
To the spreading corruption.
Well, it was dropping little pods, right? There were like little pods and there were seeds in there, and, you know, I would open the pods. It looked like green beans, kind of. I don't know what kind of tree it was, but that's how it, you know, spread its seed, I suppose. And this particular tree dropped a lot of these fuckers. And I remember I opened up one of them and this nasty, like, giant beetle was inside. And these were big pods. And this, it was like just a weird fucking beetle, or just a weird bug in general. And from that day forward, I hated trees. There's a secret room. Okay, I'll get it after this. Thanks for the heads up. It's 111 there, Wug. Not making it up, Majora's Disaster. That's actually a true story. All of these stories are true tonight. Except for the one that I said was a lie. So we're gonna play Truth, Truth, Lie. But I'll tell you when a story's made up as soon as I tell it. So don't worry about that. Also, look at this level of stress because this motherfucker lived. The crone lived and it caused me that much stress. You know what the crazy thing is, I have to actually spend a turn killing the crone. Give them no quarter. By the way, there was a dildo in the tree. That's what it was. No, it's true though. I did find a bug inside of a pod. And it sucked. And it made me not want to, like, be around that tree ever again. That is really, really true. Boring. Like a particularly boring story, but true nonetheless. Sometimes a tree is just a tree, though.
Eradicated.
Mom, Vinny lied about purple slug. He said there was a slug inside of a tent, and well, now I can't trust anyone ever. But because he lied. Can we get, like, a decent heal on Willoughby? I guess that's fine. Fuck it, let's get rid of the, stress. This is a good stress relief team. They give each other, hand relief whenever needed. Weaken. Now I'm just gonna debuff this motherfucker. Jesus. Fucking Jesus. Hey, Padre. God damn it. Just gonna get another turn in. Why does he keep going for the leper? Stop, dude.
Monstrous size has no intrinsic merit, unless inordinate exsanguination be considered a virtue.
Chirurgian's charm? Chirurgian's charm, okay. That reminds me of the word Chaturga from Eternal Darkness, but I don't know what the fuck Chirurgian means.
The light, the promise of safety.
have bandage. Sadly, I do not have bandage. Oh, man. Oh, no. Follett. Follett. Oh, the secret room. Fuck. After this battle, for sure. God damn it. Come on, I need a good heal. 12, fine. Buff the party a little bit. Rip that, you can go. You can fuck right off. The Enchantress is next. Oh, dear God. What have you done? Oh, no. Fucking die! Oh, God. HP left. Nice. Good heal.
Slowly, gently. This is how a life is taken.
These fucking attacks. Mark the target early so that more damage can be done. Good. Just a few more attacks like that. Good dodge. Here, in the midst of this intense battle, let me play you the tune of my people. I saw a very nice mandolin at the music store today, and I almost bought it, but I then realized I do not need a mandolin, and all I would ever do is try to play Battle of Evermore, or Going to California once each, and then never use it again. So I just got the strings on my Rickenbacker changed. That's it. But it was a cool looking mandolin.
Yeah, one! Yeah, plus bleed! Yeah, good!
Mount, so too will resistance.
I'm now being shamed for not changing the strings on a guitar I don't know how to change the strings for. Don't fucking kink shame me, bro. So what? What if it's my fetish to have someone else change my strings on my guitar?
As the light gains purchase, spirits are lifted, and purpose is made clear.
Don't have a bandage. Oh, look at that. The occultist only has one charm. I can actually do that. That's good. Where's the secret? Here, it's right here. There we go. Yes.
Packs laden with loot.
Fuck yeah.
Are often low on supplies.
Oh, God,
the match is struck. A blazing star is born.
Don't need this, I don't think. That's really, really good cash. Food. Oh god, I'm running out of food. And I still haven't camped yet. Yeah, the Rickenbacker I haven't had to change- oh my god. The Rickenbacker I haven't had to change the strings for, because I mainly used it for recording. And I actually had not attempted. So when I got to the music store, I just said, hey, maybe, we can, you know, do this and I can learn. Because I actually had no idea how to change the strings on it. It's a little complicated compared to my Jaguar. But not too much more. Now I know how to do it, but I figured today I could just have it done. So that's why. Oh, and also because I'm a cuck, according to the chat. That too. Here. I need a good heal. That's a good heal. I'll take it. With no bleeding, too. Oh yeah, I do have a bandage. Okay, I'll use this now. Oh! What's that cool heal? Knocked him out, stunned him. That's an amazing bleed effect, by the way. 12 bleed is absolutely fucking stunning.
The bigger
the
beast,
we go.
The greater the glory.
What's this to fucking discard this stuff? Okay, I'm gonna hit this next room, I'm gonna camp. No, don't investigate! Oh, alright. I was gonna say, we gotta use the herbs. I didn't get a chance to use the herbs.
A moment of respite.
Well,
a chance to steal
a little bit of healing
against the coming horrors.
Are you kidding? None of the people in this party have a heal move. We're just gonna buff. I mean, removing stress is good too, but... maybe if you actually use the survivalist.
The path is clear. We require only the strength to follow it.
I know how much the stream enjoys watching me fiddle through menus.
In Radiance, may we find victory.
Oh, whoops. Then again, I suppose if I'm really worried about the stream not watching me fiddle through menus, then I suppose the best course of action would be probably not to stream this game. Or Chrono Cross. Because many menus are in both this and Chrono Cross. Just don't stream at all, I guess. Yeah, that's actually a good idea.
Without tools of iron, you must rely on flesh.
Love that.
Indefatigable purpose.
Love that massive vine so much.
A fortune waiting to be spent.
Okay, really, like, getting uneasy, okay, I didn't see that either.
Ancient.
Really becoming uneasy.
Unsprung and thirsting for blood.
Oh, thank God. Okay, I did it. I'm not even gonna explore. I'm done. I'm good. Returning to Hamlet.
Paths and roads bring soldiers and supplies.
I was gonna say, I haven't seen a battle in a long-ass time. Alright, we're good. We're good. Torn Rotator, minus 5% damage to melee, we gotta get rid of that. Stout, that's pretty good.
Woe to the sheep. Or does the absence of the shepherd not invite the wolves?
Transept is locked, cloister costs minus 50%. Penance Hall minus 50%. Cool. I really probably shouldn't play this game when I'm, like, just about to go to bed. I find myself making more questionable decisions. Wait, what is this? Hang on a second. What is this? Who do I need to get healed? Willoughby, you do not like to do- I think Willoughby just wants a drink. Alright, so Willoughby just- yeah, you can just drink. Good. Have fun. So that's a pretty good amount of money to have. Oh, I'm gonna get rid of some of the- well, Willoughby had something I wanted to get rid of, but never mind. Let's get rid of another disease, possibly. Yeah, diseases can really just fuck off right about now, and that would be great. Wait, Vaudeville had a bunch of diseases. Oh, they're all gone at once. Okay, good. Dismas has some fun diseases. Rabies? He gets extra damage from rabies. I kind of want Murdoch to keep rabies. Okay. Any other stress need to be relieved? I'm sure there's some fun things to do in this filthy old town. There's okay, here's your options for stress relief if you want to have fun. Get shit-faced, gamble,
whores,
as Danny DeVito would say, or God. Lots of God. Possibly getting whipped, which some people are into. I won't fucking shame you for that. Like I said, don't shame me. My fetish is getting my guitar strings changed by another person. That said, you know, there's not a whole lot to do in this town. So I'm gonna assume that maybe the brothel could get you a disease. Maybe even the bar could get you a disease if it's bad drink. God can't save you from diseases. So there's almost nothing to do that doesn't involve you getting, like, murdered or hurt. And adventuring is all well and good, but, you know. What are you gonna do with adventuring if you have some sort of, like, you know, horrible, horrible disease? Also, these are pretty expensive. I want to save my money, and I want to use it for, like, skills and stuff. But I'm actually done, guys. Like I said, the convention kind of fucked my sleep schedule up a bit. You know, for the better, actually. I was waking up earlier, and I'm really just too tired. I'm making a lot of mistakes in this game. I'm, like, kind of barely paying attention, and it's time for me to go to bed. I'll probably stream Darkest Dungeon again sometime in the next few weeks, maybe in the next week, and I'll do it more awake, so I won't be quite as dumb with it. I did, another thing is I streamed a Game of Thrones episode half season discussion earlier, and that lasted about 2 hours, so that's kind of why I started so late. and also lost some of my voice. But I'll check the art first, of course, and then I'll go to bed. But I don't know, maybe I'll be around tomorrow. I know I have a studio tomorrow. I'm going to be working on some new things. And also, I want to start Wolfenstein soon. I just have to install it first. And also, I want to finish Grow Home. And then, hopefully, I can finish Grow Home, finish Chrono Cross, start Wolfenstein, and then we begin a new phase of streams. And when I get my 3DS back, we can finish Kirby as well.